Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have just discussed the definition of SCADA. SCADA stands for Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition. Okay, and for that purpose, to transfer the information, we have discussed what is meant by telemetry, in which we are going to collect the data and transfer the data to the central location. Now, today we will discuss about the data acquisition. What is meant by data acquisition? Simply, data acquisition means collection of the data from the various sensors which are placed on the various instruments or devices or the machinery, from which we will collect the data and we will just send the data to the control room. That is called as the data acquisition. So data acquisitions refers to the method used to access and control the information or data from the equipment being controlled and monitored. The data access are then forwarded onto the telemetry system ready for transfer to the different sites. They can be analog or digital information gathered by sensors such as flow meter, ammeter, etc. It can also be data to control the equipment such as actuator, relay, valves, motor, etc. So basically in our data acquisition, what you are going to do, we are collecting the data. Okay, for what purpose? To access and control information. Okay, and from which devices? The devices which need to be monitored and controlled. डेटा एक्विजिशन मध्ये आपण काय करणार आहे, डेटा एक्विजिशन मध्ये आपण डेटा कलेक्ट करणार आहे. कोणत्या इंस्ट्रुमेंटचा जे आपल्याला कंट्रोल करायचे आहेत किंवा मॉनिटर करायचे आहेत. ओके, आणि तो डेटा आपण सेंड करणार आहे थ्रू टेलिमेट्री सिस्टीम. ओके, टेलिमेट्री सिस्टीम मे बी युअर वायर्ड सिस्टीम ऑर इट मे बी अ वायरलेस सिस्टीम. ओके, बेसिकली ड्यूरिंग फॉर वायर सिस्टीम वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द Ethernet cables, that may be Cat5, Cat6 cables to transfer the data, and if it is a wireless system, that time you are going to use ZigBee or you are going to use the radio waves to transfer the data from one location to another location. Whatever the data we are going to collect it, the data may be either analog data. Your analog data may be your physical parameters such as temperature, pressure, speed, velocity. Okay, signals of this one, or it may be digital data. Digital data stands for the switches, okay, or certain types of relays and all these things. We are going to gather this data from various sensors. Okay, that sensors might be temperature sensor, it may be a flow meter, it may be ammeter, voltmeter, anything, and we can send this data to the control equipments. Okay, what are your output equipments or output devices? That may be actuators, that may be relays, that may be valves, that may be motors. So we are going to gather the data, send to the control system. In control system, that data is going to be analyzed, and after analysis, then they will take the appropriate actions. Either they will energize the actuators or de-energize the actuator relays or something. Then what are the basic components of the SCADA system? So basically there are four components of SCADA system, major components. First one is your field instrumentation. Various sensors and actuators which are placed on the field, that refers to the field instrumentation. The field instrumentation consists of both input sensors as well as output actuators. Okay, the sensors might be your temperature sensor, pressure sensor. Okay, and output devices might be your relays, valves, motor, actuators. Then we have the remote stations which are placed near the field instrumentation or on the field. Then third one is the communication network. This communication network will carry the signals from field instrumentation remote station to the control room. And the last part of here is the control station monitoring. So basically this is your SCADA system, just general is block diagram. So this is my field. I have one motor and something is over there. So I have used these two sensors. The green color indicates that the field instrumentation. Okay, with the green color we are going to use the indicate the first part, that is field instrumentation. That may be a sensors or actuators. Then we have the remote station. Okay, this remote station is placed near the field through which I can just change certain parameters like this one. Okay, and then I have the communication network. What are the signals from these field instrumentations and remote stations we are going to transmit to the control central monitoring system. Okay, so this is my communication channel. That communication channel might be a wired network or it may be a wireless network. Depending on your requirement, you either you can go for wired or you can go for wireless. So basically in the industry we are going to prefer the wired communication network over there, and for that purpose we are going to use the Ethernet cables. That might be Cat6, Cat5, or nowadays we can also go for the fiber optic cables to transfer the signals. That is a lossless system. Now, the signals will come to the central monitoring system. What are the data which is acquired over here, or this is collected over here, that comes to the central monitoring system. Now on this monitor, whatever the field that is going to be simulated over here, whatever the operations are going to be carried out over here, exactly the same operation you can observe on the screen, and whatever the data is going to be appear over here, that is going to be appear on your monitor, and we can control it from this location. Whatever this field device is, the distance may be few meters, that may be few hundreds of meter, few thousands of meter, it may be certain hundreds of kilometer, or it may be thousands of kilometer. Okay, so you can control your system from any corner of the world or any corner of the globe over here. Even in space also, we are going to control it. Such as example, if you are going to observe certain movies like Mars Mission, Mission Mangal, or so, in that case, what they are going to do, they are going to control the rover which was sent on the Mars for the Mars mission from the Earth substation. So that is the example of your SCADA system over there. Okay, so with this, we can control the parameters. Either you can start the system, stop the system from the central monitoring system. Okay, so this is your basic components of. Now we are going to just take the close look over this. What is meant by field instrumentation? Field instrumentation refer to the sensors and actuators that are directly interfaced to the plant or equipment. They generate analog and digital signals that will be monitored by the remote station. Signals are also conditioned to make sure they are compatible with the inputs and output of RTU. What RTU stands for? Remote Terminal Unit, or PLC at the remote station. Now, the basic function of field instrumentation is what? They will collect the information. Okay, and they are directly interfaced with the plant or equipment, machinery. Field instrumentation madhe je sensors ki actuators asil. Sensor related to your input devices, actuator related to the output devices. They are directly connected to the plant or equipment. Okay, and they are going to generate this type of data. Okay, either data might be analog data or it may be a digital data. And this is given to the, and this data signal will be monitored by the remote station. Okay, at that plant locations or the equipment, near the equipment, there is a remote station that is going to be monitored data and take the appropriate action, or depending on the certain parameters, it will take certain actions. Okay, the operator will take the certain action by observing or monitoring the parameters. Signals are conditioned. Now basically what I tell, these signals might be having low strength, or it may be weak signals. So, or sometimes it may be a more signals, means the strength may be high. So we are going to monitor the signal. The signal may consist of noise or something. So we are going to use the signal conditioning circuit over here, and we are going to just condition the signals and make them compatible with the input output of the RTU. Basically, remote terminal unit and PLC will designed to operate on only DC signals. That may be 12 volt, that may be 24 volt, or that may be 48 volt. So most commonly used signals are 12 volt or 24 volt DC signal. So whatever the signal strength is there, that is going to be converted into the signal which is handled by the RTU or the PLC. So for that purpose, you need to do the signal conditioning over here. Then next part is the remote station. The remote station is installed at the remote plant or equipment, being monitored and controlled by the central host computer. This can be remote terminal unit, or it may be a programmable logic unit. So basically, at the remote stations, say if it is a large machine or something, we are going to place a dedicated PLC or remote terminal over there, and that is going to be do the monitoring and controlling of the process over there for that purpose. Then next one is the communication network. It is a medium for transferring the information from one location to another. This can be via telephone line, or it may be a radio, or it may be cables. So communication network is very important thing. If I want to transfer the signal from my remote terminal or from the field devices to the central monitoring systems, then I have to use the communication networks. That communication network might be your wired communication network by using telephone lines or cables, or it may be wireless by using the radio signals. Then the last part of this one is the central monitoring station, that refers to the CMS. CMS to the location of the master and host computer. Several workstations may be configured on the CMS. If necessary, it uses the man-machine interface, that is MMI. Okay, man-machine interface can be used for this program to monitor the various types of data needed for the operation. So basically, my CMS, central monitoring station, consists of the MMI or HMI. Okay, so MMI is the man machine interface. Sometimes it is also called as the HMI, human machine interface. Okay, so you can interface with that and you can control the devices which are working on the field from any corner of the world or from any locations or through the control system by just clicking over there. On the control system server, you can get the actual whatever happened in the field. That system is going to be simulated over there, and you can see each and every operation over there with the time accuracy of microsecond. So in the next lecture, we will discuss about in detail about the what is field instrumentation and detail of all these things.